Okay, now today we specify in detail the heat exchangers. Allora, we proceed in this way. We build an alias of the heat exchanging blocks in a part in the flowsheet. So we can modify them without jeopardizing the simulation.
Okay.
Allora, for example, allora, in theory, one should size in detail any heat exchanger on the flowsheet, everyone, both the regenerative ones and the others. Allora, in practice, we will start doing a couple of them just to learn the method. Allora, forse alcuni nel file che vi ho passato vi trovate già un alias del 411. Allora, adesso ne facciamo un altro. Primo perché questo, purtroppo vi ho passato il file con lo scambiatore già fatto e vabbè, mi sono dimenticato di salvare il file senza. Però poi è anche uno scambiatore un po' difficile, mi sono accorto facendolo. E quindi è anche meglio farne un altro. Abbiate pazienza, mi è scappata. Allora, for example, we may start assessing the heat exchanger H410. Now,
okay.
We proceed in this way. Look. Allora, you go in the model palette and pick up heat X. Allora, heat X is the most rigorous block that Aspen Plus has to model the heat exchangers. So, and I put a D beside this detail. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
I don't like using this block in the early stages of a simulation because this block has many, many, many options that up to now would have been useless. You see that we already reached, we already built a quite complex simulation, assessing all the mass and energy balances without using any of the detailed information that we can find inside here. Nevertheless, how do we go on? Allora, we have to connect the strings. So, for example, here we have saturated water as cold input. So, cold input, it will be an alias of this stream. No, it exists. Then how do we call it? 28 D feed water. Okay, this is the cold input and this is the cold product. The hot stream is the reaction product that is progressively losing heat. So, hot. I've run out of letters. Okay.
E. Okay.
Okay. Now, Now, to let the simulation run, I have to put some specification in the input stream. But I don't need to put detailed specification because afterwards I will build the transfer block to transfer the data exactly. So, just as initial guess, I put pressure, temperature, and more or less approximate mole flow. So. Ok, 144 degrees, 4 bars, and more or less 1600 kmol per hour of water. That's it. Now, hot side. Hot side. We have 563 degrees, 2.2 bars, all the water, more or less the recycled benzene, and more or less the produced styrene. Don't worry to put exact numbers, because just after doing this, we build a transfer block to handle the data transfer. So, model analysis, no, flow sheeting options, transfer. Allora. Pro 2. Allora, from stream for mix 33B to stream 33F. Ok. Now we need another transfer for the water. From 28B to 28D. Okay, be careful, pick up the exact names in your flow sheet.
They are the same as yours.
I don't know. DB to 28. Ok. Now, inside the heat exchanger, you see that we have plenty of options that we didn't have before. Allora, model fidelity. For now, select shortcut. Shortcut counter current for now va bene. Calculation mode. Allora, we start selecting design, then we will see how the others work. Specification. Allora, what were the specification of the original heat exchanger? Vapor fraction 95%. So, cold stream outlet vapor fraction 95%. U method, allora, this is one of the main differences. Allora, you see that we can put a constant heat transfer coefficient, Or we can put transfer coefficient depending from the phases. Allora, I usually like to compilate this table. So, for example, liquid-liquid 85 watt square meter and Kelvin is good enough. Liquid boiling, maybe 2000 is more realistic. Liquid vapor, it's something between 30 and 50. Condensing liquid is like liquid boiling, more or less. Condensing boiling, 3000. Condensing vapor, 50. Vapor liquid is like liquid vapor. Vapor boiling is like condensing vapor. Vapor vapor, no more than 20. Even 20 is quite high. Well, this is the basic options. Here you can see other things. For example, include profile report, okay. Pressure drop, for now we don't calculate it. I will show you how to calculate it in detail. Allora, this tab, guys, may be quite important, but remember, this is the correction factor for the logarithmic mean temperature difference. Okay?
Okay.
Ve la ricordate dell'esame della Rossetti, il fattore di correzione?
Devo ancora farlo.
Vabbè, praticamente è un fattore di correzione che consente di mappare uno scambiatore reale su uno scambiatore ideale.
Ok.
Ci sono due parametri, il famoso parametro R e il famoso parametro Q, che dipendono essenzialmente dal flusso dei fluidi. Dal flusso e dal loro delta T. Quando il flusso e il delta T sono fuori da un certo range, la temperatura media logaritmica non è più quella ideale calcolata, ma deve essere riscalata da un certo fattore. Ok, anyway, for now we can assume 0.9 and forget about it. Vai su block options.
Ok.
Allora,
quello è l'altro side, però.
Prova a mettere gli R components cold side.
Ok, R components cold side.
Ok. Now, we'll let run the simulation. Ok, and I see the results. Allora, this block is quite rich in letting you examine the results. You have the thermal results. So, you have inlet and outlet for the different streams, cold and hot, the heat duty. You have the global mass and energy balance like in any Aspen Plus block. And now you have some more detail. For example, the most important parameter you get here is the required heat exchanger area.
Okay.
That is based on the duty and on the average U. See?
Yes.
The program returns the heat exchange coefficient based on the table that we have input before. And now it has calculated the area, dividing the duty for the heat exchange coefficient. And then we have also the logarithmic mean temperature difference. Allora, up to now, it's more or less respect to the original block. We have added only one information, the heat exchange coefficient and the area. Now, Aspen Plus has given us the required heat exchanger area. Now, we can, with this datum, we can explore the other simulation options. Now, for example, if you switch from design to rating, you see that now the inputs are not complete anymore.
Yes.
Because the rating mode means that you tell Aspen what is the global heat exchange property of the block. And Aspen Plus provides an answer saying if the block is good enough to accomplish its task. For example, I put 1,000 square meter of area. Ok.
Sappiamo che è troppo piccola.
I let it run. And I control the thermal results. I change the details. Ok. Aspen Plus tells me that with this heat exchange coefficient of 50, with this heat duty, I would need an area of 1,500 square meters. So the exchange area of 1,000 square meters is undersized. This heat exchanger is 33% under design.
Okay.
Well, this option is very good if you are working and doing some retrofit. Cioè, for example, you have an already existing heat exchanger with a known area. You would like to use this heat exchanger to do this job. Aspen Plus tells if the heat exchanger is good enough. Notice that the cold stream and hot stream outlet temperatures are the good ones. Okay. Because after Aspen Plus keeps the result that you found before in the design mode. In fact, you see that the specification and the area must be both specified, even if their result would be conflicting. So Aspen keeps the specification and the U value and calculate the required area. Then keeps the actual area and calculate if the heat exchanger is undersized or oversized. Okay. The last mode available is simulation. So, what would happen if I kept an exchange area of 1,000 square meter? Okay, you run the simulation. Now, in this case, you see that Aspen used the input area and the input heat exchange coefficient to calculate how things would go in reality. And so this means that the hot stream would remain at 300 degrees and the cold stream would not be vaporized at 95%, but only at 79%.
Yes.
Okay. Allora, there is also a last option that is less used, that is maximum cooling. Allora, we cannot use easy in this modality. We have to go to other advanced options. Anyway, this is needed to calculate if there are margin in our heat exchanger for the cooling resistance. Allora, let's now come back to design mode.
Okay.
Allora, this heat exchanger has a boiling liquid on the cold side, okay, and a vapor on the hot side. So usually this heat exchanger can be a shell and tube or a kettle reboiler. Okay, for example, we select kettle reboiler. Size exchanger, size interactively. Ok.
Nel senso che te lo dimensiona lui?
No, nel senso che adesso questi sono i parametri con cui lavorare. Allora, you can choose shallow tube or kettle reboiler. Allora, usually the most common type when you have a boiling liquid is kettle reboiler.
Okay.
Important thing is not to choose plate. Air cooled, no, because we want to heat up, not to cool. Thermosiphon is a very particular thing, don't worry about it. Plate, no, because plate heat exchanger are for liquid-liquid heat exchange. Not heat, not liquid vapor. Actually, an heat exchanger like this could be a kettle reboiler or a vertical shell and tube. So we keep kettle reboiler. Okay, we click on convert. Okay, allora, practically we have opened up inside Asper Plus a tool of the heat exchange design.
Yes.
Okay. Allora, these are the main information of the geometry. Our thema type are just the mechanical specification. You can neglect them. Location of hot fluid, tube side, okay. Okay. Because the philosophy of this exchanger is that the shell side have to accommodate the expanding vapor. While in the tubes there is the hot fluid.
Okay.
Allora, these are the information for the tube dimension and arrangement. And we see carbon steel. Allora, the type of material has an effect on the heat exchange coefficient, guys. but also on the maintenance of the... Allora, carbon steel is the worst type of material, is the cheapest, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Allora, usually the cheapest option that, come si dice, carbon steel is the cheapest, but has many problems of corrosion and maintenance.
Okay.
So, you should pick up, it depends. Allora, since we have a large logarithmic mean temperature difference available, you don't need copper or aluminium. But you must choose a stainless steel or an Inconel. Stainless steel is cheaper than Inconel.
Mm-hmm.
These numbers refer to the diameter. Okay. Since we have low pressures, we need also a little thickness. Nevertheless, this is not very important. It's just to do a choice more realistic than carbon steel.
Mm-hmm.
Allora. Now, we see what Aspen calculates for the diameters. Allora, in this tab, you see a recap of the process parameters.
Yes.
Allora, unfortunately, the default measure unit are Anglo-Saxon. Okay. This you specify available pressure drops. Allora, these are relatively high. Okay. We can keep this number as a start. But are quite high numbers. So if we can get less, it would be good.
Eccolo.
Ok. Eh sì, anche me ha fatto così, poi me l'ha tirati fuori.
Simone, la prossima lezione la fai tu allora, questa volta sei tu che stai aspettando. Cazzo, ma prima di metterla su YouTube vi rendete conto di che taglia in cui ci devo fare questa registrazione?
Sarà bella lunga,
oh,
sì.
Entrerò nel magico mondo del montaggio, lì veramente... Il bello che poi su, quando su YouTube vedete un video tutto bello, infighettato, è sto falsone. Allora... Errors and warnings. Two warnings on the input. No maximum level pressure drop was specified for the stream. And you did not input any full resistance. These are minor issues from our point of view. Operation. Okay. There were zero supports specified. This is a matter for mechanical engineers, not for us. Flow induced vibration has identified problems. Two warnings, of which two serious. Resonance assessment, three warnings, of which two serious. Allora, this means basically, guys, that probably the fluid in the heat exchanger is going too fast.
Okay.
But anyway, you are chemically, you are industrial chemist. You don't have to keep in mind all these things. Because these are problems for the mechanical engineer.
No, okay.
Don't worry for now. This means basically that the fluid is too fast. Process. Allora, you can see what Aspen has found out. Allora, you see that here, these are the process parameter calculated. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And these are what Aspen foresees for the geometries. Allora, this graphic means that Aspen foresees two paths in the tubes. Sì?
Mm-hmm.
Number of tubes per path. And 1080 tubes with this diameter at this pitch. Allora, the pitch, guys, is the space between the axes of two tubes.
Okay.
Allora, if you click on tube layout, you should see something like that. This is a cross-sectional view of you, of your heat exchanger.
Mm-hmm.
Allora, you could also tell Aspen to use less tubes, if you want.
Mm-hmm.
If you click save, you can save the file.
Fuck, non lo so.
This is the first thing to do. Yes. Then, if you can click accept design, now you switch to the calculation mode simulation.
Yes.
Now it means that, as before, Aspen will do the simulation using the real heat exchanger, but the real heat exchanger is no more represented by an area and a heat exchange coefficient only, ma is represented by a full design as calculated via the heat exchanger design rating. Now, if you click on ADR browser, you have all the heat exchange design rating program available inside Aspen Plus. Sì.
Yes.
Allora, in theory, you could also open the heat exchanger design file externally. Allora, what is the difference? I will show you presently. Allora, let's start Aspen ADR externally. As a standalone. And open the file. Allora, no, ho aperto quello sbagliato.
È quello vecchio, mi sa.
Oh, ma sono proprio impedito oggi. Voi avete aperto quello giusto?
Sto aprendo.
Allora, what is the difference? Allora, sì. If you open the file externally, you have the design, rating, and simulation options all available. If you open it inside Aspen Plus, you can go with simulation only. So, if you work on your heat exchanger from inside Aspen Plus, then you keep your work on the geometry and see what happens to the streams. Instead, if you work externally with the heat exchanger design rating opened standalone, you can do everything. So, for example, you can design to respect the process parameter, you can rate the heat exchanger respecting the process parameter, or you can do a simulation. This is the main difference between open the heat exchanger design and rating alone, or open it inside Aspen Plus. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Nevertheless, you can close it. No. So, working from inside Aspen Plus, allora, the main thing that I wanted to show, allora, are these. Allora. By default, you are placed on the console. The console, you see, it's a quick interface to manipulate the main variables and obtain a quick result. Everything that you see in the console can be seen in detail in the other sheets. For example, property data. Allora, here you see that the property data for the fluids are inherited from Aspen Plus.
Mm-hmm.
For example, the cold stream should be essentially water. At least where it is liquid. Okay. Nevertheless, the good point of opening it exchanger from inside Aspen Plus is that you don't have to worry to compilate this part. If you start a project from the scratch on it exchanger designer rating, you have to compile also the table of the properties. And so on and so on. Allora, in this case, you don't have to worry because everything that is needed is already calculated. Exchanger geometry. Now you can see the geometry in detail.
Mm-hmm.
So, for example, Aspen Plus calculates that you can go with 1,000 tubes of 1 meter and 35, while the shell should be 90 centimeters. Here you have other geometry details. Allora, program options, allora, design options, but thermal analysis. Allora, allora, you see that the liquid transfer heat transfer coefficient and the vapor heat transfer coefficient are not specified. Why? Because if you pick up this tab, method correlation, you see that Aspen Plus calculates it. Allora, this is a great advantage of the heat exchanger designer rating respect to the basic options that we have in Aspen Plus. Because with this calculation method based on correlation, Aspen Plus calculates automatically the heat exchange, the heat exchanger heat transfer coefficient. For example, pick up the result summary. Allora, let's start from overall summary. Don't open the tema sheet for now. Allora, here you have the overall calculation of your design.
Yes.
Allora, Aspen Plus here is considering three shells in parallel. That means three separated heat exchangers to do the job. Allora, this is not strange. Because if you let Aspen Plus do the sizing automatically, The program keeps into consideration optimization factors. Remember also that you are sizing a real process. So the plant is really large. Very big heat exchangers are very expensive. This basically means that the Aspen design rating has found that there three small heat exchanger guys cost less than one very big heat exchanger. You get what I mean?
Stato un calo di internet.
This is because the price of heat exchanger is not linear with its size. So Aspen Plus Intel is that three small heat exchanger cost less than one very big.
Ah, okay.
This is one result of the optimization. You can mess with these parameters here when you have the optimization parameters options. Calculation method and stuff. Geometry, shell. Allora, qua queste ve le ho già raccontate, sì. Allora, spendita, che cos'è? Position, ok. Allora, dov'è che era? Optimization path. Allora, here in the optimization path, you see that the heat exchanger design rating has repeated the calculation 21 times, each time varying some geometrical parameter. And has calculated also the cost. Then it has found that the case number 14 has the less cost. Pronto?
Ok.
Ci stiamo seguendo.
Allora, why? You see that the key parameter is the area ratio. The area ratio is the calculated area basing on the geometry respect to the minimal area required to accomplish the task from the thermal point of view. You see that, for example, the case number 14 is just the second for the area ratio. And is slightly cheapest than the case number 18 because allora there are more tubes, but probably there is something in the dimension that makes case number 14 better than case number 18. Okay, the shell numbers. So you see that all the cases with one shell, so one heat exchanger, are not the best from a point of view of the expended money. This may seem a paradox, but is not. Because you see how the size changes. If I have one shell, they are 58 inches in diameters on. Less shell, I have little diameter, and so less material. And this thing doesn't go linearly. Now, let's return to the overall summary. We have the process data that we knew from Aspen Plus. Allora, the real advantage of design rating, I said, it is that we have the real heat exchange coefficient and we have also the pressure drop. Allora, example, for the shell side, we have 1.73 psi of 7.25. So a little pressure drop. Tube side, the pressure drop is 2.6 out of 3.2 allowed. Allora, the velocity. We have only 3 feet per second at the inlet. But we have 27 feet per second at the outlet. Allora, keep in mind that shell side inlet is a liquid. Shell side outlet is a vapor.
Okay.
Okay, allora, so these are, these numbers are relatively low. Because these are feet, not meters. So
in non metro, nemmeno un metro al secondo.
I would have 1 meter per second at the inlet. Allora, 1 meter per second, guys, for water, it's low. Okay? I mean, yes. It's not too low, but it's slightly below the average. Water should be between 1 and 3.
Okay.
Okay, now this is vapor, so it is more or less 10 meters per second.
Okay.
Okay, also vapor speed could be higher. Nevertheless, this value it's good enough for this calculation, let's say. Allora, tube side, you see that the velocity is a completely different order of magnitude, okay? Nevertheless, when we are inside a heat exchanger tube, not inside the process pipe, the rule of thumbs changes completely. So there are no easy values to compare this velocity with. What is important in this case is the pressure drop and the vibration assessment. So you are an industrial chemist, so the vibration assessment for you is autoscope. But as industrial chemistry, you must keep in consideration the pressure drop.
Okay.
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 So if you see a too high pressure drop, you have to work to reduce the tube side velocity.
Okay.
Now, you see, tube side heat exchange coefficient 53 in British thermal unit and stuff. tube wall, this depends on the material that we have chosen.
Okay.
And this is the shell side film heat transfer coefficient. This you have the pressure drop in detail. So for each geometrical section of the exchanger. Allora, thermal hydraulic, these are more or less the same things, but with more detail. Allora, this bar below is very interesting. Allora, it tells you that the heat transfer resistance is nearly all attributable to the tube side. Oh, well, this is quite obvious, guys, because we are in a reboiler. So, from the shell side, we have a boiling fluid, a very high heat transfer coefficient.
Okay.
You cannot change this figure in a reboiler. This is clear. Pronto?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I don't think all of us have it very clear. Could you give a further explanation on this, please?
Allora, beh, in un reboiler, Chantal, tu hai... Allora, dentro i tubi noi stiamo facendo passare un vapore caldo, ok? Mm-hmm. Mentre fuori c'è acqua che bolle. E il coefficiente di scambio termico per un vapore caldo di riffa di là, allora qua ce lo dà in British Thermal Unit ora piede quadrato Fahrenheit.
Ma wow.
Allora, this is the overall heat transfer coefficient, 288. Ok? I surmised before, I had surmised 100. So, it's not very bad because I got the exact order of magnitude. Now, heat transfer. Ok. Overall fuel coefficient, vapor sensible at 13,000 in watt square meter Kelvin. Well, from the tube side, 300, that is typical for it is relatively high. It's because the vapor is in pressure. Allora, praticamente il vero motivo, Chantal, è che quando un fluido sta cambiando di fase, tu non hai in gioco il calore sensibile, hai in gioco il calore latente, ok? Sì. Bene. Quindi succede che le goccioline di vapore, le bollicine di vapore che si formano nel liquido saturo o le gocce di liquido che si formano nel vapore saturo praticamente scambiano tutto il calore latente, non il calore sensibile, senza cambiare temperatura.
Ok.
È per questo che i coefficienti di scambio termico delle cose in cambiamento di fase sono così mostruosamente alti.
Ok. Adesso mi è più chiara perché ci sono questi numeri.
Ok.
Grazie.
Il risultato è questo. Tube side non hai cambiamento di fase, quindi hai una grande resistenza. Mentre shell side hai una piccola resistenza.
Ok.
Oh, fully resistance, we didn't specify identity. Highest velocity. Pressure drop. Ok. 0.18 tube side. Is it still acceptable? Here you have the pressure drop in detail, and so on. Okay, this is the quickest way to take advantage of the heat exchanger designer rating. Allora, only one thing. Heat exchanger coefficient. Allora, keep in mind that these results may not be absolutely right, okay? So, if you have literature data to compare these numbers, it is better that you use that.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't feel confidence with this calculation, allora, you can always go to the calculation... dove? Allora. No, you can go dove cazzo era? Methods correlation input. Allora, transfer, you can specify them. Okay.
Ah, okay.
If you don't want to rely on the Aspect Plus calculation, make the... Cioè, if you don't feel confident to let it calculate with this method, you can override it, specifying it here.
Okay.
If you have literature data for particular fluid in particular condition, you can use it there. Also for the pressure drop. You can use all the correction factor that you want. Here you find the, this is for the vibration, this is for the heat transfer. Single phase heat transfer, you can choose these options. Here you have vaporization, otherwise you would have another single phase. So next thing to play with the heat exchanger designer rating inside Aspect Plus, for example, you can use heat exchanger designer rating to specify the condenser air boiler of a column. Okay, for example, pick column number 11.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Allora, go to reboiler. Allora, yes. You click on Reboiler Wizard. Ok, allora, heat exchanger specification and flash block ID. Now, what does it mean? It means that Aspen Plus will allow you to specify in a rigorous way how the reboiler is done. The reboiler will be divided in a heat exchanger block plus a flash block. What is the good point of the reboiler wizard? The reboiler wizard, it means that Aspen Plus will create a fake stream, S1, that represent the flow of liquid and vapor just above the reboiler. This stream will be carried to the reboiler to do the specification, but the distillation column will not be affected. So in other words, you don't have to specify a column without the reboiler and then to build separately your reboiler using a heat exchanger. you can keep your distillation column as it is. And you will build your heat exchanger using a pseudo stream that accounts for the vapor and liquid flow. Allora, heat exchanger specification, I call it call 11 reb. If you click on shortcut, the heat exchanger will be a normal heatx of Aspen Plus. If you click on shell and tube, the heat exchanger will be done with the heat exchanger design and rating. Our input file, we don't have one for now. So Aspen Plus will create a new one. Flash block, preboiler flash. Andiamo. Okay, this will be the name of the block.
Okay.
Maintaining this block. Okay. Now see what I have here. All this stuff, guys, represent the column reboiler. You can play with this stuff without affecting your column.
Okay.
So PS1 is the flow from the stage right above the reboiler to the reboiler. Stream 2 is this stream after being vaporized. And this flash block carries away the separation of the liquid product from the vapor that re-enters the column. So stream 6, guys, has to match our product styrene stream. Stream 5 is the reflux of the stripping section of the column. Stream 3 and stream 4 represent the hot utility. Okay?
Okay.
So, for example, in this case, the reboiler temperature is relatively low, 110 degrees. So, as a hot utility, I will have low pressure steam. Vapor fraction 1, pressure 4 bars. Let's say, for example, 100 kmol per hour of water. Let's see if this quantity of vapor is enough. Then I ask to specify the blocks. Allora, the flash is already specified by Aspen. It is a separator, just a simple separator. The heat exchanger has to be specified by us. Allora, you see that these are the default values provided by Aspen. Allora, the duty is not 1 kilowatt, guys. It was 10 kilowatt. So we can correct this. Nevertheless, remember that if you are in design mode, also a wrong value of heat exchanger duty would not affect the simulation. Because in design mode, Aspen calculate the actual value required. Okay. Allora, le bare visa. Allora, if I let it run, I get an error on this block. Let's see why. Specify duty is higher than outside maximum. Allora, outside maximum. What does it mean? I don't know actually. I try specify more vapor flow. Allora, warning while generating resin for new pressure block. Possible vibration problem. Oh, I don't care about it. So now we can evaluate the results. Allora, here we have the calculated D2D. This change of the details. Required area 500 square meters. Actual area 646 square meters. And this is the average heat exchange coefficient. Allora, this we have the heat exchanger designer rating response. Pressure drop. Setting plan. And the profiles. Okay. In this case, we have a flat temperature profile on the hot side because we are heating heat with vapor, saturated steam. On the cold side, the temperature profile is not flat because styrene finishes to be purified in the reboiler. Allora, notice that the flows are different. See, guys.
Yes.
This depends from the fact that che dipende. Interessante. Aspen is telling us that if the heat exchanger would be like this, probably you would not get all the styrene that the column was specified to produce. Now, How can I modify this? Oh, well, these are my process parameters. Allora, the best thing to do in this case okay. I try to see if this method works. It's not granted. Okay. Now I get even more styrene than desired, than what desired. Okay. And I have the results changed accordingly. A slightly different in beauty, a slightly different area, and so on. In any case, if you want to know the details, you click ADR browser and you explore all the results from here.